first half, you got to be really proud of the way you guys came out. And you got hot early, and I think that sparked everybody.
Yeah, we definitely played really well in the beginning. Everybody all around hit shots and controlled it, and we had it, got into a quick early lead, and they couldn't come back from there.
Second half was a little disappointing because, you know, Shaq is a very important part of their team.
Absolutely. And I mean, that's huge. That was huge because he's definitely explosive. He could catch fire at any point. And we knew before the game that we had to control him. So.
How important is it to be playing well going into Asbury Park?
We're playing our best basketball right now. We peaked at the perfect time. So, I mean, we have a big game coming up. We kind of a little revenge against Asbury Park since my sophomore year when we lost to them. So we definitely want to come out there with a win.
First half wasn't great for you guys, but the second half had to be a huge downer without Shaq. What's he mean to you guys?
I mean, he a lot. He's the best player on the team.
Did that kind of take the air out of your sails when you realized that he couldn't go for the second half?
Yeah, it took it out of everybody. We down a lot, and we needed him to bring us back. And it just, I don't know, everybody stopped caring.
Your senior year has to be a memorable year. There's still a lot of great things that happened this year. How much fun did you have this year with your boys?
I mean, I had a lot of fun, except the 11 games we lost, 11, 12 games. But, I mean, even that was fun. It was all fun. I loved it.
You got to be very pleased with the first half. It was almost textbook basketball, I thought.
I just think we're playing very good right now. I mean, the guys are really playing together, balls moving around, different guys in every night stepping up in big situations. And in the last couple of games in the playoffs here, we're really, really finding our groove. So we hope we can continue that Tuesday night.
Now, obviously, you want to win the game, but how disappointing to look down at the end of the bench and see that a kid like Shaquille Butler can't go in the second half. It's got to break your heart.
Shaquille Butler has always been a class act. Since he's been there, he shakes my hand before every single game. I talk to him at the banquet. I feel so sad that he didn't get to play his second half. He's a much improved basketball player from where he was as a freshman. He was always a shooter, but he really worked hard on his game to get a lot better. And like I said, me and my brother were talking about it before. It's sad to see a kid who's been a class act for 4 years. So I do feel bad, but I don't think that's the end of Shaquille Butler's basketball career either. He's a college basketball player.
Talk about preparing for Asbury. You guys aren't going to have to do any work motivating these guys. All these guys remember 2 years ago.
Yeah, 2 years ago was tough. You're going to see the same physical play. It's going to be traps and presses and things like that. I thought we did a nice job of handling pressure tonight from a fast team. If we can limit our turnovers, you know, I think we're a pretty good half-court team. So if we can get it into a half-court game, I think we have a good chance. You know, and again, I don't think we're scared of the press. We just gotta take care of the basketball.